government needs to stop this immediately. See what youth are doing again after curfew imposition by government. Few hours ago, Lagos State government ordered imposition of curfew on Lagos incident entirely due to the destruction of public and private properties in the name of ENSA's protests. The actions was taken by the government because the youth have misused the opportunity given to them by Lagos State governor. For instance, now look at the police station they built at Orile Igamu today, which is not making any sense at all. This is why government take these hard steps before the situation would get out of hands. But despite the declaration of curfew by Lagos State governor, youth have taken another dimension which is brutal than the one they are doing before. What they are displaying in the cardboard is very scary. The cardboard contains write-ups which goes like this: either they like it or not, these people, these so-called criminals, would definitely leave no matter what. They also wrote in this placard that President Muhammadu Buhari should leave if he refused to let this be. So I'm urging the government to please solve this problem with immediate effect. The action was taken by the government because the youth have misused the opportunity given to them by Lagos State governor. This is why government take this hard step before the situation would get out of hand. What they are displaying in the cardboard is very scary. Followed by ENSA-men, the ENSA-s end bad governments, we want advance payments. That is what they wrote on this cardboard. You can confirm this in the picture below as an evidence of the reports. If you observe the current situation after curfew imposition in the picture posted above, you will see these youth are ready to do whatever it takes to make their request granted by federal government. So government needs to stop this immediately in order to ensure the safety of innocent people in Lagos State and Nigeria entirely. As a reasonable person, do you think destruction of properties can solve the problems of this country? Thank you, viewers, for listening to this news. That question that is being asked now should be answered correctly and with immediate effects. Imagine, why is it that people, after people being that have been paid, they keep seeing and saying negative things about something that is not real? Look at what this writer is saying, because he has been paid. He has been paid by these so-called sponsors of these criminals. If they are successful, you benefit from it. They sacrifice their lives to make it better for selfish people like our government. They organize a curfew that we can never come to an existence, that the people will never abide by. Someone who is a total confused man. You can't stop them, can't stop it, protesters from protesting. This is just the beginning. You're just deceiving yourselves. You're just planning on what will never be possible. Just deceiving yourself and wasting your time. Be expecting more from the so-called government office. Because even if they keep announcing curfew from now to a year, that's when the youth and the protesters will never abide by it. They can never stay at home. Don't you know that if they follow this, if they abide by the curfew, whatever that is given by the government will think that they are cowards. This is why they have decided never to listen to whatsoever curfew that is being released by the so-called government. Let's be honest. Do you think that these innocent children that are technocrats, do you think they will listen to this so-called government concerning by organizing or by putting a curfew on the road? they will never listen to these people. Do you think so? Do you think these academicians can act like thugs? Answer my questions. Answer. Government, they cut their lives short because of money. The lost are the target of a few, just for a few days. They equate lives with money. They exchange their lives with money. If someone had killed you, you would not even live to become governor today. Is it because they have not been killed and their families are still safe? This is why they are doing whatever they like. This is why they are nice announcing curfew in each state. Is that why? The yoke of this innocent youth will hang on them, on their necks. Those that have been killed, those that were attacked and killed, their soul, their blood will be on their neck. When peaceful and quiet protest leaders do nothing to allow you to survive, they complain about their plight peacefully, you still kill them. Your leaders are creating jungles for Nigerians. Instead of them granting their requests, they keep sending thugs to harass them. They keep sending thugs to destroy their properties and kill them. This is not fair. This is not fair. These people are standing on their ground that enough is enough. Enough of police brutality. Enough of sacks. Enough of bribery. Enough of corruption. Is it a crime for someone to come out and protest against such an abominable act? Instead of granting their request, you're sending thugs to destroy and to kill them one after the other. This is not fair. This is not fair at all. The protesters, Nigerians, can never stop moving out from their domain. They can't. They'll keep protesting until their request is being granted. So viewers, you have heard it all from the writer. What would you have to say concerning this? The comment concerning this news is very much important. Drop them below the comment box. Click on the subscription button as well as the bell button to receive updates whenever I publish new videos. Thank you.